Amen. Welcome to this online Fun on Sunday morning service. You can hear me in an empty and echoing St. Thomas's Church. Whilst we cannot gather together physically, we will gather together in our hearts and we'll gather together with God. God is good. All the time. All the time, God is good.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like this. Worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name, sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. Come, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul, worship His holy name. Worship your holy name, Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never.
Today we'll be thinking about the parable of the talents. We'll be thinking about what talent means within the context of that parable. We'll think about what it means within the context of this church and what it means to us. But as we gather, let us pray. Heavenly Lord, you long for the world's salvation. Stir us from apathy. Restrain us from excess, and revive in us new hope that all creation will one day be healed in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so now we're going to have our Bible reading.
Our reading today is from Matthew 25, chapter 14 to 30. For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the two talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, Master, you handed me over 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. And the one with 2 talents also came forward, saying, Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trusty slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here, you have what is yours. But his master replied, You wicked and lazy slave. You knew, did you, that I would reap where I did not sow and gather where I would not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talents from him and give it to one of the ten talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
So thank you, Julie, for that gospel reading. In the gospel, Jesus was explaining about the gifts which we are given, and he uses the parable of the talents. Now, in the English translation, we understand talents in two ways, but in the way that Jesus was describing it, he was talking about a weight of money. So a talent was about 30 to 36 kilos in weight, huge sum of money. And it's been described that a talent was about 10 years' wages. So to one he gave 50 years' wages worth of money. To another he gave 20 years' worth of money. And to the last he gave 10 years' worth of money. Huge sums of money, to which the first two went off and they invested their talents. They worked them and doubled them. And the third squandered his talent because he didn't allow it to grow. He didn't allow it to make anything at all. And so it brings us very much onto our craft for today, because we are getting ready for Advent. It's very strange getting ready for Advent, but we're getting ready for Advent nonetheless. And as we're getting ready for Advent, Advent leads on to Christmas, and Christmas is a time of giving. And so I'd like us to think about what it means to give, because the talents which we have been given are both financial and they are figurative. They are the gifts and the skills which we have. And so I'd like us to think about what we can give, what we can give to others, what we can give to God. And so our craft for today is we're going to be building reverse Advent boxes. So I'm going to hold up this little display and hopefully this will work as well. Which is, we have in your packs, in the email sent out, a flat cutout of a box. So I'm going to lay it down here. And hopefully we can see in there. So I'm going to cut between the two cameras. And so for this, not only are you going to need to print out your box, ideally you're going to need a pair of scissors, a craft knife if you have it, but that's not essential. I'm going to use that just because it's a little bit easier for me, and a glue stick of some variety. And so what we're going to do is we're going to cut out this box, and then we're going to construct it. Maybe you want to decorate as well as you build it. I haven't, because I haven't got the skills to be that artistic. But those talents are things which you have. So we're going to cut here, and we're going to cut it out, and we're going to start making our box. And so when you've worked your way around, you'll find that the box is all nicely cut out. And so you can get rid of that excess then. If you need to trim up any bits, you can do as well. Let's go take this edge off here as well to make it nice and neat. And so we're going to get rid of all these excess bits. And so now you're left with your cut out box. But it's still very flat. But if you look round, we've got where it says glue, and we've got that middle bit to cut out, and we've got those dotty edges as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out that middle bit, and then we're going to fold in at the dotty edges, and then we will start fixing our box. So this is the time, if you want to decorate it, this is a good time to do it, because this is the way which we can do so whilst it's still flat. But once it's made into a box, it's a little bit more difficult. So when you get it all cut out, you can start folding on the dotty lines, and you can all see, because actually I started bending all these pieces together, it suddenly starts becoming the shape of a little box. And so we're just going to fold those last couple of bits, those dotty lines, and make nice crisp creases. And there you'll see the box, it wants to become a box now, doesn't it? So if you fold it up, even without any glue, you'll suddenly find it will take that shape of a box. And so that's when you get your glue stick, lay out your box flat again, and we're going to go and just put a dab of glue on the edge all the way round. And so keep gluing all the way around. Make sure all the bits which say glue on them have a bit of glue. And then when they're ready, you can fold the whole thing together and it'll look something like this. And so here you can see, this is one I prepared just before I came. And the box on top, there's a nice slot there to put any money and donations in. But this is our reverse Advent box. And so what I'd like you to do is, as we get towards Advent, I'd like you, when you're opening your Advent calendar, maybe it's a paper one with beautiful pictures, or maybe it's a chocolate one with something scrummy to eat, I'd like you to put something in there. Just put a little bit of money, whatever you might wish to do, and we will use that money. We're going to bring that money together at Christmas. And we're going to give thanks to God for the talents that he has given to us, how we've allowed them, by bringing them together, to multiply them. And we can then give that money to CMS and to Aru. And we're going to be able to actually support the work which CMS is doing. For those who are doing the Advent calendars, you'll be supporting that little girl in Ghana and for her schooling and everything else, which is absolutely brilliant. But there's more than just that which we've got within our craft pack. So that's our physical craft which we're going to make. And we've also got a few other bits and pieces. So we've got something which is a bit of fun, which is a maze, an amazing maze. And it gets us thinking about that parable. So written around here is the parable we heard, which Julie read for us. And down here, we've got our talents. To one, five, to another, two, and to the third one, one. And if you follow up the maze, you'll find how they made their talents grow, and we can work out how many talents we got at the end as well. The other thing which we have is our word search. And so the word search, there are lots of brilliant words in there. And this is actually that talent of observation, of focus, of being able to see things which are hidden. And it's a very good talent to develop. And lastly, we've got something for us all to reflect on. This is not just for the children, this is for the adults as well. And actually, it's something which I need to do as well. Is what are my talents? What are my gifts? What are my skills? What's my ability? What do I do that others can't? What do I do that I can offer to others than I can offer to God? And so there's a few lines there. If you want to just think about things which you find particularly easy. And it may be things like, actually, I can make friends really easily. I'm good at actually making people feel comfortable. It might be, I'm really strong. I've got a really strong back and I can do hard work. It might be, I've got a gift with numbers or a gift with words or anything. There are no limits to the possibilities. Maybe you're a musician. Maybe you've got those talents. And so it's really for us to all think about, what are my talents? What am I particularly good at? What is really good for being me? And there's also things for us to work out. So once we've actually kind of discovered our talents, we need to spend a bit of time, effort, perfecting them. Some of us are very lucky. Some of us have got these skills which we are incredibly good at with very little effort. But for most of us, we need to spend that little bit of time, a little bit of effort and energy, making our talents really shine. And that's what that parable talks about. When the one with the five and the one with the two went off and invested their talents, they're putting their time and their efforts into it to make them grow. And so that's when we say about actually time and effort and thinking about our talents. That's what we're thinking about. It's actually thinking about how we make our talents grow. And then we talk about having faith. Because actually, the parable is talking about how we grow as people, how we grow and how we increase the things which God has given to us. And we can't do that without a bit of faith, without a bit of prayer. Because God gave us all these gifts, and we need him with us to help those grow. We then need to think about how we learn the skills. Because actually, you know, you could be really good at music, but you need the dexterity to actually have that skill to do it. They say it takes about 10,000 hours of practice to master a skill. That sounds like a lot, but when you start adding it up, it will soon fly by. And then we have to practice our talent. Because that third servant, he went and hid his talent to the ground, and then had taken away from him. We need to use and practice our talent. Because if we don't practice it, it will go to waste. And so what we have been given will be taken away from us. And actually, you'll find that
If you don't practice your gift and your skill, you'll suddenly find that those things which you found easy suddenly become harder again. And lastly, we should share our talent. So yes, today we've been talking about what we can give with our reverse Advent boxes and our reverse Advent calendars. But actually, the talents which we have, and this is where I use the alternative phrase, those gifts and those skills, is about what we can offer to others. How can we give rather than receive? Because that's what Christmas is about. Christmas is about God giving his son to the world. Not just to us, not just to those who lived a couple of centuries ago in Judea, but to the entire world. God loves us so much that he gave his son to us. That amazing gift. And that's why we have presents at Christmas. It's so we can celebrate the gift that God has given to us. He didn't hold it back. So we too, we need to share our talent with others and with the church. We need to say, you know what? I can do that. I can offer that. I'm going to practice my skill. I'm going to share it with other people and give. Not thinking about the reward, but giving because it's the right thing to do. Giving because by giving, you are allowing others to flourish. And that's a brilliant thing and something which needs to be commended. So I hope you enjoy making these boxes. I hope you enjoy the word search and the maze. But I'd like you really to sit down with your families and just think, what are my talents? What are my gifts and my skills? And you may sometimes not actually realize that that's what it is. Because it comes so naturally and something which you just do that you don't realize that is the gift and the skill which you possess. So I look forward at Christmas. We can bring in our Advent boxes. We can bring them and we'll put them in front of this altar here. We will give thanks for them and the work which they will go on to do. Don't hide your talent. Don't let it fester. Don't bury it in the ground. Put those talents to work. Allow them to grow. Allow your talents to be shared with others so that they may be grown with what you do. Because when we all share our talents together, we all grow. And the more we grow, the more we can share. The more we share, the more we can grow. And so it goes on and on and on in a brilliant and wonderful way. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, you have given us gifts and skills and talents. Help us to hone those skills, to share those talents. Help us to be aware that we all have gifts. Help us to make those gifts work to your glory. May we give without thought of reward. May we share freely with those things which have been given to us. May we build each other up in companionship and friendship, in well-wishing and showing that all gifts and skills and talents are valued. Help us to be bold. Help us so that we do not hide our talent away or bury it. Help us to exercise those talents that they may grow to your glory. Help us to be generous in what we do, so that all may come to you and know you, and that may that through our work they may see your love. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so I'm going to invite you to say with me the prayer which Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
So I hope you found the craft and the talk interesting today. I really do look forward to being able to gather in December and then at Christmas time, where we can bring our boxes together to give those gifts to CMS, and for those who are doing the Advent calendar, those gifts to Ghana. Do keep developing your talents. We are in strange times, but we can still grow as people, as Christians, as followers of Christ. We will gather again, and when we do, we will celebrate. We will get through all the restrictions and all the challenges we have. So hold firm and keep the faith. So I invite you to join me in the final blessing and the dismissal. The Lord be with you, and also with you. May the Lord bless you and keep you, and make his face to shine upon you. And the blessed God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Hello, we are Peter and Patricia, dressed up in our special outfits for World Women's Day. You may remember us from when Peter was Reverend Peter in Colnbrook. Since then, we have been serving in the Democratic Republic of Congo with Church Mission Society.
DR Congo is a very big country in the middle of Africa. We are living in Aru, which is right up in the top right-hand corner of Congo.
We are very thankful that all of you in Fun on Sunday Morning want to support our work with Church Mission Society during this coming Advent, and we are sure the children we have met so far will be very grateful too. There are a lot of children in Congo, and wherever we see them, they are very welcoming.
Here in this little film, you see a view from the car when we made our first parish visit to understand the needs of the people. The children were running in front of us up the bumpy dirt track. If you listen very carefully, you can hear them singing Karibu, which means welcome.
There are two groups of children in different villages. You can see they live mostly in the countryside. They love to take me on a walk through their neighborhoods when we visit. If you look carefully, you can see some huts in the background, which is where most of them live. These huts are cool in the hot weather, but they can be very leaky when it rains. And they are also having roofs that can burn when embers from the fires fall on the roof.
Sunday school is very popular in Congo, but there are quite a few problems because there are just so many children. In our own parish, in the cathedral in Aru, there are maybe 100 children in each class, 4 classes, 400 children, but each class is in a very small room. These are the Sunday school children singing in their choir in the cathedral before they go out into their classes. You can see how many they are. It's actually very difficult for the teachers to manage so many children, and it's difficult for the children to understand the Bible stories.
We will say our goodbyes now, and thank you very much for watching. We know the children will now be waving at you, and thank you very much for not forgetting them during this time of Advent. Bye.
Bye-bye.